Detained former Philippine Senator Laila De Lima scores a legal victory as bribery charges against her are junked by the Office of the Ombudsman. The complaints alleging that De Lima received over 8 million pesos in bribe from self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa were dismissed due to lack of probable cause. The Ombudsman's ruling was dated January 5th this year, but was only received by De Lima's camp on Tuesday. The funds in question were supposedly used to finance De Lima's 2016 senatorial bid. Also cleared of bribery charges is De Lima's former bodyguard, Ronnie Dayan, who was accused of receiving the bribe from Espinosa on behalf of the former senator. The ombudsman cites inconsistencies in the testimonies against De Lima by Espinosa and another witness, Marcelo Adorco. Espinosa recanted his statement against De Lima in April and admitted he was only forced to make the claims against her.
The Philippine economy's growth momentum slows in the second quarter of the year. But as Juan de Guzman tells us, Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno remains upbeat on the country's prospects.
The Philippine economy grew 7.4% in the April to June period. This was slower than the first quarter's expansion of 8.2%, slower than the second quarter 2021 growth rate of 12.1%, and slower than most economists' expectation. Economic managers say the slowdown may be attributed to the impact of inflation on manufacturing, services, and household spending.
Manufacturing sector's growth decelerated to 2.1% in the second quarter, down from 22.4% in the same quarter last year. The slowdown was due to weaker growth in computers, electronics, and optical products, chemical and chemical products, and food products. The slowdown may be due to inflationary pressures brought about by the Russia-Ukraine war, weakening global demand, and supply chain disruptions brought by lockdowns in China.
The seasonally adjusted quarter-on-quarter growth rate for services sector declined by 0.4%. We also noted that the seasonally adjusted household final consumption expenditure for the second quarter was also reduced to negative 2.7% from the first quarter of 2.1%.
The Philippine government has been fighting inflation by augmenting local food supply through importation. Unfortunately, it is also dependent on the global market for commodities like fuel. This policy has led to a balance of trade deficit of $5.843 billion, the largest ever based on records at the Philippine Statistics Authority. The Philippine Central Bank, meanwhile, has been hiking interest rates to address shifting monetary policy settings in the United States and to anchor inflation expectations moving forward by making it more expensive for consumers and businesses to buy commodities using borrowed money. Former Finance Secretary Roberto De Ocampo, however, says this lever must be adjusted carefully.
Kailangan mong kontrolin ang inflation, pero huwag mong sobrahin sapagkat kailangan din ang ekonomiya pag sinobra mo ang interest rate mo. Sa pagkocontrol ng inflation, baka hindi naman makabukas sa mga business sapagkat masyado mahal ng loans, etc. At ito po ang ginagawa, no? Nagagumagawa ng combination of pagkataas ng interest rate na hindi naman sobra-sobra at ang pagtulong ng pamahalaan sa pagbaba ng presyo at pagtulong sa ating mga mas mahirap na mamamayan.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla declined to comment on how the GDP report might impact monetary policy. However, he says he was not surprised by the second quarter numbers. Medalla has been projecting a 25 to 50 basis point rate hike ahead of the Monetary Board's August 18th rate-setting meeting. RCBC economist Michael Ricafort says rising interest rates here and abroad could slow new investments. That's bad news, as the Philippines is in need of more capital to spur economic activity. Management Association of the Philippines President Roelio Singson says the second quarter numbers show a clear need for more private sector investment in manufacturing and agriculture to create new jobs and improve food security. Finance Secretary Ben Jokno is not worried. He expects economic growth to hit within the revised forecast range of 6.5 to 7.5% this year, noting growth only needs to average 5.2% in the second half to hit the lower end of the target. The economic team also noted the 7.4% expansion in the second quarter is actually the second highest in the ASEAN region, behind only Vietnam's 7.7% growth, although some countries like Thailand and Malaysia have yet to report. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.